There's a lot of rating stuff. So, okay. So the one thing that I found intriguing. So the SmackDown, like, it won't be until Tuesday when we're going to know the actual SmackDown number. I mean, I know that was the idea is like, we got the prelim number and it wasn't lower than last week. So it's not like they're falling off a cliff like they were, you know, before. There was like the fear, because Raw's gone, you know, down to that level, that, and SmackDown was way down last week as compared to previous weeks, that maybe they're falling. And maybe they do end up down. Maybe they end up a little bit. You know, the prelim number was up, but, you know, it wasn't up by much. So, we don't know exactly where they're at. And then the thing that I'm most interested in, because it's kind of like this week, I could kind of, the one thing that we could learn from this week, and they are higher than they were when they were doing 04s on, you know, when they were doing the 04s. That was bad on Friday Night Network TV when everybody else is in reruns and you're doing 04s with a first run show. But now they've been, you know, they were at 06 2 weeks ago. They were 05 last week. This week it looks like they're going to be between an 05 and an 06, which is fine, because when you were, you know, when you're doing 04s, it's fine that you're up a little bit from that. But the thing that is interesting to me is, okay, so both AW and SmackDown went head to head with the finals of the Stanley Cup. This is not preliminary rounds. This is the final round, and it's a week because of the teams involved. It's, you know, was it Tampa Bay and Dallas? It's a weak final as far as marquee national. The ratings are down because it's not popular teams, you know, with national, big national followings. So AEW, on Wednesday, they were both on cable. You know, the Stanley Cup was on NBC Sports Network and AEW's on TNT. And they both did 0.32, so they essentially tied. So what is interesting to me is now that they're both on network on Friday night, so it was on NBC versus Fox, what's going to happen? We don't know the Stanley Cup number because the preliminary number doesn't include the West Coast. So we don't know exactly what it is, but it's probably going to be pretty close. So what basically we're going to learn is, you know, and it's essentially, what's the difference between being on cable and being on the network? Like, when AEW is doing a 0.32 and WWE is doing like a 0.4 on the network, AEW is, if they were on the network, they would easily beat that, okay? At a 0.5 or a 0.6, we don't know. So the thing is if the Stanley Cup and SmackDown tie, and both on network, the Stanley Cup and AEW tie, both on cable, it's pretty much telling you that if SmackDown was on cable or AEW was on network, they're probably going to be pretty competitive and pretty even at this point. I mean, I guess we'll know during the World Series for sure, when, you know, SmackDown goes to the 1 week SmackDown goes to cable. But it basically tells us in comparison with the exact same series with the exact same teams, exactly where they're, you know, if SmackDown beats them by a lot, then they're ahead of AEW. If SmackDown loses by a little, then, you know, but I mean, anyway, Tuesday, we'll have all this on Tuesday, but I'm very interested in this because it's pretty much, you know, that kind of tells you like where they really are, because there's a big, big difference between network and cable. So as far as like the SmackDown number, you know, it was a little over 2 million in the Fast Nationals. So we didn't really get a big read other than it's not as big as it was a few weeks ago when Roman Reigns first came back and they first went into the Thunderdome, but it's certainly not falling to a great degree, and it's better than it was when they were at the Performance Center. So that's, we're still at that. It's not a disaster. It's not good. Unlike Raw, which has been low. now. And we'll probably have a tough time. There's a lot of people who think Monday's Raw will be the lowest of all time because of the football game. Because it's the biggest game of the season so far, and it's the biggest Monday night game that will be, in theory, all season. So they think that, like, this will be the one that will be the record low. I don't know, because, again, day after the pay-per-view, that's going to help. If it wasn't the day after the pay-per-view and coming off of that really bad show last week, I would expect a record low, but I don't expect a record low this time.
I actually don't think the day after the pay-per-view is going to mean much of anything, because it's not a big pay-per-view. It's not like a SummerSlam. I mean, we're going down the card, and aside from Randy Orton and Drew McIntyre, I mean, maybe if they change the title, like, people will tune in and see Randy Orton.
But they may do a big angle. They made you a big angle. That's what they try to do on pay-per-views, is to do something that will intrigue you.
What would that
you.
Big angle be?
I don't know. I don't know what they're going to do. But I mean, if they do something with some intrigue, if they just do a bunch of matches and there's no intrigue when it's over, no, being the day after the pay-per-view is not going to help them too much. But they may change the title. That might get some interest. They may do a real fluke finish. They may try to do a big angle in some form. They may do stuff, to set up, stuff to set up the next pay-per-view. Who knows what? You know, they know they've got to do stuff. I mean, they know they can't sit and do nothing, because they know that. So I don't know. I don't know what they're going to do.
They had a SummerSlam show with a payback pay-per-view a week later, and they did nothing for it on SummerSlam.
No,
so I do not think they're going to do anything on this show for Hell in a Cell.
Okay, but both of those shows, the ratings were up. They got very good ratings by the standards of what Raw's been doing after the last two pay-per-views.
So, yeah, they were in the Thunderdome for the first time.
Yeah, then the second week wasn't a novelty as much anymore, and they still got.
It's still the second week.
Yeah, but
I will hereby predict that it will be the lowest Raw rating of all time on Monday. Let's just do it that way.
Okay, I predict it will not be.
All right,
I predict it will not be the lowest of all time. I don't expect it to be a great number, though, by any means. So, and everything's going to be. I'll tell you what, the news channels are going to be way up. From this point, because of the election. So, I mean, I think everything's going to take kind of a hit. So there wasn't really a lot to the Wednesday stuff other than, obviously the, NXT had that real big lead in, and they opened with 1,205,000 viewers, which was huge in the first minute. And, the first quarter of NXT was their, I think it was their highest head to head quarter in a long, long time. They had over 900,000 viewers. That's really big for them. But then it fell. They had a decent, the first quarter was big, and it wasn't because of the Women's Battle Royal. It was because of the lead-in, because they went from 1,205,000 to, 896,000 in like 4 minutes. And the second quarter, which was the finish of the Battle Royal, was in the sevens. Let me get the number. It was 754. So they lost a lot quickly, but they had the benefit of the big lead in and won the first quarter. By the 45-minute mark was when the whole thing turned around, which was the Orange Cassidy Brody Lee match, AEW, and then the Cody run in did big, and then AEW pretty much the whole second hour doubled them in 18-49s. I mean, it was big advantage. So, but it's normal. It's a normal stuff. It's about what they've been doing. And they were, they had the hockey, and the basketball. They both had the same competition. But the 18-49 number, considering what they were against, AEW did pretty well, especially from, the Cassidy match on, pretty much everything from there. What was the final for the Moxley? It was 461 for the Moxley Eddie Kingston match in 18-49 to 204, which was the gauntlet eliminator for the title shot on TakeOver. So it's well over double